Hello everyone, in this video lecture we will discuss the BJT operation, bipolar junction transistor operation. So to operate any electronic devices, the external supply has to be given. So since the bipolar junction transistor has two junction, junction J1 and J2, where J1 is between emitter and base terminal, junction J2 is between base and collector terminal. So we can give the external supplies in four ways, where by making J1 and J2 both forward bias or both reverse bias, where J1 has forward bias, J2 has reverse bias, or reverse bias and forward bias. Based on that, the operating regions are considered for bipolar junction transistor. When both J1 and J2 are forward bias, that operating region is called as saturation region. When both are reverse bias, that is called as cutoff region. When input or J1 is forward bias and the output J2 is reverse bias, that is considered as active region. When input region is reverse bias and the output junction is forward bias, that is called as breakdown region. So when the bipolar junction transistor is operated in saturation region and cutoff region, the BJT can be used as switch here. So this is one of the application of BJT. When it is operated in saturation and cutoff region, it can be used as switch. When the BJT is operated in active region, the BJT can be used as amplifier here. So in case of saturation and cutoff region, it can be used as switch. In case of active region, the BJT can be used as amplifier here. So for the better understanding, we'll consider when the transistor is operated in active region. So we'll consider the NPN transistor. So since it is operated in active region, the junction J1 should be forward bias and junction J2 should be reverse bias. So the junction J1, that is between N and P, should be forward bias. So the negative terminal of a battery is connected to N type and the positive terminal of a battery is connected to P-type to make forward bias. Similarly, J2 should be reverse bias. So P-type is connected with negative terminal of a battery and the N-type semiconducting region is connected with positive terminal of a battery. So after giving the external supply, connecting the batteries to the device, as we all seen in the previous videos, that the operation of PN junction diode when it is biased, both in case of forward bias and reverse bias. Since at the input side, here it is forward bias. The majority charge carriers in N-type are electrons here and the minority charge carriers are holes. In case of P-type, holes are the majority charge carriers and electrons are the minority charge carriers. Here also in case of collector, N-type is majority charge carriers are electrons and minority charge carriers are holes. As soon as we connect the batteries, these electrons will get repulsive force from the negative terminal of a battery and they start moving in the opposite direction here. They start moving from N-type to P-type here. Once they reach the P-type here, these electrons will undergo recombination. Once they undergo recombination, since the doping concentration of base terminal is very less and the doping concentration of emitter terminal is larger compared to base and collector, the more number of charge carriers will get transferred from emitter here. So they will cross the junction J2 and reaches collector region also. So and the remaining charge carriers will go pass through the base terminal here. If we consider N number of electrons are coming from emitter region, we'll say that alpha times N number of electrons are reaching the collector region and 1 minus alpha times N number of electrons are passing through the base terminal. That means if I'm considering when the electrons present here will get repulsive force from the negative terminal of a battery, so that if I'm considering 100 electrons are started moving from the emitter terminal here, emitter region, and since the doping concentration of the base terminal is very less, we'll assume that only one electron will undergo recombination and that will pass through the base region. So here if it is 100, means one electron is going through the base terminal, and the 99 electrons will reaches the collector region here. So this is the operation of bipolar junction transistor in case of input terminal, so input side forward bias here. Since there is a movement of charge carrier here, that is from emitter to base, electrons are moving and the holes will move from base to emitter here. There is a movement of charge carrier, so it will contribute for flow of current here. Since the electrons are moving from emitter to base, the emitter current will be in the opposite to the flow of charge carrier's electron, that is IE. This is, and similarly in case of base current also, electrons are moving in this direction, the base current will be into the transistor, that is IB. This is for junction J1 when it is forward bias. When we are considering the junction J2, that is reverse bias here. We all know that in case of reverse bias, only the minority charge carriers will contribute for flow of current because they cross the junction here. So the electrons are the minority charge carriers in base and the holes are the minority charge carriers in collector. They will cross the junction. So the minority charge carriers will cross the junction. They will contribute for flow of current here. So that current is called as reverse saturation current. But in case of collector here, already we have seen emitter current and base current. The collector current in both minority charge carrier electron and the charge carriers coming from emitter to collector, both are moving in the same direction. So the direction of collector current will be opposite to the direction of flow of electrons. So that is into the transistor IC. But this collector current is contributed by two components here. One is the charge carriers coming from emitter to collector and the minority charge carriers moving from base to collector here. So IC will be given as IC is equal to the charge carriers coming from emitter to collector is alpha times. So alpha times IE plus the charge carriers contributing for the minority charge carriers are contributing for flow of current here, yes, that is reverse saturation current. I'll call it as ICO. There are two components, charge carriers coming from emitter region and the contributed from minority charge carrier reverse saturation current. So this is how the bipolar junction transistor operates here. So when we are finding the relation between the currents, terminal currents here, so as we know, IC is equal to alpha times IE plus ICO, where ICO is reverse saturation current, IE is emitter terminal current and IC is collector terminal current. If you apply the KCL at this point, the current to this BJT transistor, the current leaving the junction is emitter current and current entering the junctions are base current and collector current. So that I'll call this as one. We can write by applying KCL, we can write IE is equal to IC plus IB. I'll call this as equation 2. By substituting equation 2 in 1, so the collector current 2 in 1, the collector current will become IC is equal to alpha times, in place of IE we can write it as IC plus IB plus ICO. So if I'm rewriting by solving this, alpha times IC, if I'm taking to the left hand side, IC, so that is 1 minus alpha times IC is equal to alpha times IB plus ICO. So if I rewrite this current, IC is equal to alpha by 1 minus alpha into IB plus ICO divided by 1 minus alpha. So here alpha by 1 minus alpha is nothing but it is equal to beta, and beta alpha can be written as beta by 1 plus beta is equal to alpha, where this beta is nothing but the current gain in common emitter configuration and the alpha is current gain in common base configuration. Since it is a common base configuration, we are taken as alpha here. So if I'm rewriting this equation alpha by 1 minus alpha can be replaced by beta, where IC is equal to beta times IB plus, so by substituting in place of alpha beta by 1 plus beta, that is 1 by 1 minus beta by 1 plus beta into ICO. So if I'm simplifying this one, this equation will become IC is equal to beta times IB plus 1 plus beta times ICO. So this is the equation for the relation between the currents here. Since the reverse saturation current ICO is contributed from minority charge carriers which are having less numbers, so this current can be neglected here, so that we'll get the relation between the base current and collector current as IC is equal to beta times IB. Similarly here also, if you are neglecting this reverse saturation current, IC is equal to alpha times IE. As I mentioned, in case of common base configuration, input current, input terminal is emitter and the output terminal is collector. So alpha is a current gain in common base configuration, that is output current IC by input current IE. Similarly, the beta is current gain in common emitter configuration. In case of common emitter configuration, base terminal is the input terminal and the collector terminal is the output terminal. So beta will be equal to IC by IB. This is the relation between the currents here and operation of bipolar junction transistor. Next, we will see the applications of bipolar junction transistor.